Here I am to worship, here I am to bow down, here I am to say that you're my God. You're altogether lovely, altogether worthy, altogether wonderful to me.
Okay. What kind of father would give his son a stone when he asks for bread? Yes, we've all read this. But the important thing is here. I've put it here in red. How much more will your heavenly Father give the Holy Spirit to those who ask of him? We've all read the previous verses. We've all read this. Seek and you will find. Ask and it will be given unto you. Yes. But if we read on, it says here, how much more will your heavenly Father give the Holy Spirit to those who ask of him. So ask it, claim it. Oh, by the way, one important point, this is not a second baptism. It's a misnomer. Okay, I know, even I, we call this like top line is baptism. Yes, it is baptism, but then again, it's not. It's a release of the power of the Holy Spirit. So technically, it's not a baptism, it's a release of the power of the Holy Spirit. But we still call it baptism. Okay, what will happen during the prayer session, which we'll have in a few minutes? We'll lay our hands on you and pray with you, but basically it's between you and God. We are just the instruments. We'll lay our hands on you, we will pray with you, pray for you, but basically it is between you and God. You must ask the Holy Spirit, claim the Holy Spirit, because God promised this to us. Ask and God will give it to you. Expect it to happen. Okay, different things happen to different people. Don't seek a particular kind of experience. If, like during the prayer session, your seatmate right beside you experienced something and you didn't, you know, don't look at it that way. Different people have different experiences. Just turn to the Lord and receive the new life of the Holy Spirit. Just wait. Ask, receive the Holy Spirit. Don't worry about anybody else's experience but yours. Different people will have different kinds of experiences. Okay, you know what you need? Jesus knows you very well. God knows you very well. Ask for it in faith. Okay, I'll give you an example, a few examples of what to ask for. More courage to live the Christian life, strength to fight temptation, more knowledge about God, so on and so forth. You know what you need. Ask for it. No matter how small, no matter how you think it's so foolish, it's not. To Him, it's not. Ask for it, seek it, expect it in faith. Okay, God is offering various gifts. During MC's talk last week, she mentioned several gifts of the Holy Spirit. Now, it is the same Spirit that gives us different kinds of gifts. It's written down here in this Bible verse. There's gifts of wisdom. There's gifts of knowledge. Another, a gift of faith. Healing. Prophecy. Tongues. Discerning of tongues. One and the same Spirit gives us all these gifts. One and the same Holy Spirit gives us all these gifts. And this Holy Spirit distributes each to one individually as he will. So the Holy Spirit decides on who gets what, and this is the reason why different people have different experiences. Okay, be open to whatever God wants to give you. So just like I always say, come in with an open heart and an open mind. Okay, what should our frame of mind be when we enter the prayer stations? When later on, your discussion group leader will ask you to go to a prayer station. They'll pray over you. What should our frame of mind be? First and foremost, relax. It's easier to put something in an open palm than in a clenched fist. If you're so nervous and so uptight, your palms are clenched. So we can't put anything inside it. If your palms are open, you're so relaxed, we can easily put something in your palm. Just the same. If you're uptight, if you're worried, The Holy Spirit can't enter your heart because you're thinking of too many things. The Holy Spirit can't enter your mind, can't enter your heart. Relax. Come in with an open heart and an open mind. Do not be afraid. I know, I understand. I've been there a few years ago. I was sitting there. I've been there. There's so much uncertainty. And because there is so much uncertainty, there is so much fear. But do not be afraid because God wants us to experience the Holy Spirit. He wants to give us the gifts. Okay, don't be concerned about how you will look. Don't be concerned that you look foolish. Believe me, half the time, I don't know what I'm doing here, so if there's anybody who's foolish, it's me. So I take the cake. So anything else you do, you guys, you won't be foolish because I already made myself look foolish a long time ago. So don't worry about it. We won't laugh at you. We will rejoice with you because we want you to receive the Holy Spirit. We want you to receive the Holy Spirit. That means we have done our job. And so we will rejoice with you. Don't worry that you will look foolish. Okay, if you ever receive the gift of tongues is a gift of praise. Yield to it by first asking for it. You must ask for it. Praise God in your own words. You might start by saying something like, "You're my King, you are my God, you are my salvation. I praise you, dear Lord." You might start with that. That's up to you. The Holy Spirit will form these sounds into tongues. Here's a good analogy, which is why I suggest that you always open your mouth and move your mouth and say words to praise God. It's easier to manipulate the steering wheel of a car if it's moving as compared to when it's parked. Just the same, if you're mouth is not moving, if you're not saying something, you won't experience the gift of tongues because you're not saying anything. But if you're actually praising God and saying something, these sounds may form into tongues. Okay, resist the temptation that it is just you. It's not. It's the Holy Spirit working within you. Of course, the devil wants you to, he's always giving you that. The devil is always there saying, "Oh, it's just you. It's not God." But believe me, it is the Holy Spirit working within you. Satan is always trying to trick us, put doubt in our minds. Why? Because he's an ass, first and foremost. He's trying to trick us. He's trying to make us think that it's just us. It's not the Holy Spirit. I'll say it again, he's an ass. He's trying to convince us that it's not the Holy Spirit at work. Believe me, it is the Holy Spirit at work. To sum it all up, desire a gift from the Holy Spirit. There are gifts that we mentioned: wisdom, prophecy, knowledge, tongues, interpretation of tongues. I'll leave it up to you. You know what you need, you know what you want. Ask for it in faith. Desire a gift, ask for it in faith. If you ever ask for the gift of tongues, cooperate with the Lord. Move your lips, your mouth, say words of praise. And these words will soon become tongues. The Holy Spirit will be working with you. Okay, after you've been prayed over, you'll come back here, and the music men will be playing songs here. You can listen to them, but we want to maintain a solemn atmosphere. So you can continue praying, you can listen to the music men, or you can pray for the others who have not yet been prayed over, or you can pray for those who are in the prayer area over there. So we want to maintain a peaceful and solemn atmosphere. So please sit down, relax, keep on praying, listen to the music. Okay, a few final words. God wants us to have His gifts. He wants us. We must claim it. He wants to give these gifts to us. We must claim it. In your heart, and Jesus and God knows your hearts better than we know it ourselves. He knows our hearts better than we know it ourselves. He knows us deep down inside. So ask for it in faith. You know what you want. Claim it.